unlocks.
Nick is tweeting and asking at IGN hashtag Titanfall. Any guess as to what time today the beta emails will be sent out?
It's tomorrow.
Oh, really? I thought Vince was saying super late tonight.
Yeah.
Maybe it's like midnight.
But they're going to be rolling out. Right now, obviously, the media has been invited early to get in here, do streams, talk about it for you. Then, if you apply through that online campaign, they're starting to go out, but they're going on throughout the weekend.
Oh, what's this? So, burn cards. We had a video up on this. About IGN. Oh, can you mute everyone real quick? Back out. And people,
what is a burn card? I do not know
what that
is.
They're like perks that you can use.
Oh my god, how are they?
Is he talking to us? Is this kid answering the questions?
Okay. They are single use perks. And you can unlock three slots. We'll get all three eventually.
Like
so you can slot up to three of them for a match. So this is your deck on the right hand side. And they're little single-use perks. They last one life. If you get killed before you use it, whatever, it's gone. And you just earn them randomly as you play.
And you can sit on them forever, right? Or do you have to
You
use
could
them
totally
right
sit
now?
On them. Nope. We can pick one right now to equip. Whatever you like best.
Sure, yeah, I guess we'll go with the faster pilot movement.
Go with the other one because it's a different weapon.
You can do whatever you want.
Don't do that one.
Back to Fracture here. I really like both maps so far.
I am a huge fan of them. I feel like they're not unbalanced.
Angel City, I actually liked Angel City a lot more at first, but Fracture has really grown on me because I love the Smart Pistol so much,
this
is a total Smart Pistol paradise.
Very good for the Smart Pistol.
It's also a Sniper Rifle paradise, which I'm sure we'll see once you unlock it later. That's how you can tell when you're playing with people that have ranked up a little bit. When you start seeing the snipers on the rooftop, you must be level 8 or whatever it is.
Well, remember, ladies and gentlemen, we're doing this for an additional hour and a half Titanfall beta. It's the live stream. All of us, Greg, Ryan, Alfredo, brought to you by Boost Mobile. We're giving away a Titanfall Collector's Edition, so make sure you keep tweeting for your random chance to get that. Right now, we have a tweet from James. He says, "Hey, Ryan and Alfredo, are your brains going through a sensory overload with all this trooper mech action?"
So, not to get too, not to exaggerate too much on it, Greg, but I will say that as I've been playing this game, I'm having that rare, awesome gamer thing where my eyes start to water up because I'm actually not blinking.
You're not blinking.
Enough. There is so much going on that I'm just I'm completely transfixed by what's going on the screen.
Yeah.
And that's why, that's actually one perk of Alfredo playing, is I get to blink regularly.
You get to blink a little bit.
My optometrist will be pleased.
In the last go-around where Alfredo was doing things left, right, all this other junk, I was like, that's a lot of stuff happening. there is a lot of things happening on the screen.
And that's why, I know a lot of people are really upset about the 6-on-6 thing, that the player cap is only 12.
There you go, easy. And see, they all just stood there, right? Yeah. They didn't die.
They weren't like, hey, grenade, we should leave. Get that guy.
Kill this dude.
Fucking
I think. What was I saying?
Sensory overload. The 6-on-6. People were complaining about it.
But I mean, at least in these two maps, in these modes, I never feel like I'm bored or I'm. I feel like there's always something going on. So, I mean, I feel like is there a place for more players? Probably, but I'm perfectly happy so far with the 6-on-6.
Right. Alfredo, I saw you switched over to cloak there.
I did.
Is that something have you been using that a lot lately? Or?
I mean, it's just the obvious thing to do, right? Like, if you're in an open field and you have a cloak, use it.
Yeah.
Especially if you're about to, try to jump somebody.
Sure.
Or a Titan, for instance.
Make things just that much harder. This one I have the, the 40mm?
Yeah, that's the one I like, the tank loadout for the Atlas.
Gotta be a little
it's
more
almost like sort of a Gauss rifle type thing.
Exactly. One thing I do like a lot is that I notice that I haven't been getting spawn killed on a regular basis compared to other games. And that can get really annoying.
I really hope we get a chance to show off just punching a human from a Titan.
Oh, right. How they turn to red
mush.
My favorite is when I kill a Titan, I feel all accomplished, and then I get blown up, and I'm just two pairs of lungs sitting there. You're like, all right. Ladies and gentlemen, remember, we are going for a long time, and we want you to be part of the show. Tweet at IGN, hashtag Titanfall, just like Steve Flory did. Steve says, create an account just for the chance to win the Titanfall game giveaway.
Thanks, Steve.
You are my first tweet. He's asking, though, Do you ever take fall damage?
Nope. There is no fall damage.
Here we go! Kill him!
Damage core.
Explain the damage core. I didn't even know these existed until
this
today.
Is like a bonus you earn in your Titan after you've been in it for a while and you're doing some damage where it's basically like a temporary quad damage if you're an old school Quake fan.
Sure.
Where you're just damage is amplified. And one of the burn cards, which Alfredo we're gonna show off next game, one of those single use perks, those burn cards, is to get the damage core right when you get in your mech. So it's a temporary thing. The damage core doesn't last forever, but you stepped on him. But it is, so it's a damage core is super useful.
Now, somebody got you there, or was it your Titan exploded?
I hopped on my Titan because it was going to explode.
And then they killed you when you got out?
Yeah, because I didn't have see, that's why I like really having the auto eject.
Yeah,
so I just shot up straight to the air, as opposed to...
It's like suicide prevention in this game, basically,
sure,
right?
Sure. Ethan tweets at IGN, hashtag Titanfall, talking about what we're talking about. Is there any chance that they'll increase the amount of players allowed into one match at a time?
It doesn't seem like... they've been pretty firm about it, so...
I mean, in our industry, never say never,
exactly.
But it wouldn't be anytime soon. That would be like, wait, DLC drop-off, I would guess.
Yeah, you never know. They could do something post-release, but I think they're going to stick to their guns for the foreseeable future.
You turned the burn card, Alfredo. You're pretty cool.
Oh, well, getting there. Making moves.
Oh, God, I can't wait.
I'm trying to be aware of my...
Tomorrow, Greg. Come back to IGN at 8 a.m. tomorrow for our conversation video after you and I played South Park, Sick of Truth. And also I'll have a written preview up as well on my detailed impressions of the first couple hours of that game.
You got to play longer than I did, even. Excited to see what else you saw.
Challenges, just like Call of Duty, which of course we'll earn. The cool thing about challenges is if you complete those, for instance, there's a weapon challenge for the smart pistol, my weapon du jour, where you get enough kills with it, and it unlocks an ability to, you can, sort of an attachment for the smart pistol, not literally an attachment, but to extend the range of the smart pistol and shorten the lock-on time. So
nice.
Super useful. So, again, same thing we've seen in Call of Duty and other stuff. So
one bullet. There you go. Suck on this.
Making good use of that.
And I feel like an idiot when I pull it too early.
If you're wondering what the glowing red parts are on the Titans, as they take damage, they'll get specific vulnerable weak points. You want to try and aim for those to do extra damage.
Gotcha.
Yeah. There it is.
Alfredo, you're giving me sensory overload.
There's a lot of things going on.
My eyes are glowing.
You're rodeoing. All right, it's getting a bit quiet. Alfredo.
Yeah.
Kyle tweets at IGN, hashtag Titanfall, and says, how fast does the jetpack recharge? Does it recharge before you hit the ground?
You have to hit the ground, and then you're basically
right.
ready to go.
You have a double jump, and then... You have two jumps, and then especially from there, you have to land.
Bad news for that guy right there. The jetpack wasn't going to save him in that tube.
Buddy.
You got the cloak, right? Too late.
Oh, he got me around the... Oh, there's someone else. We're getting some other Titans.
Wow, really close game. It looks like you guys are about to win, though. Make it hot. Well, you guys win. Really close match there. I think we can pretty much say that Alfredo's the reason that your team won. He's not getting out. He's not getting out.
No mercy.
Kill that Titan!
Attack him for fun. He passed out.
They look like the robots from the original Star Wars.
They do.
The Phantom Menace. The original Star Wars.
What did you just say?
the ones that are all like, hey, you, stop over there. I don't watch much Star Wars. Anyways, be part of the show, ladies and gentlemen.
This is a friendly one.
Tweet at
IGN.
You can ride your friends.
Yep.
That's awesome.
Sounds dirty, but.
I ride my friends all the time.
Yeah. What are friends for if not for riding?
Tweet at IGN, hashtag Titanfall. You get entered to win Titanfall Clutcher.
That dropship's gonna leave. It's gone.
And the reason.
Oh, man, I thought the Titan was.
Match over. But you're making look me look this. Really good wow. right now.
You're building quite the reputation.
12 pilot kills.
Want to take over, Gray?
No.
What?
You want to see good things.
What? You, yeah, got you some... keep going. Show us the burn cards.
Yeah, yeah.
Let's take a look at the burn cards.
When... Now,
right, which burn card would you want me to use?
Well, there was actually, I mean, also, if there was one in there, you have one that actually grants you a different anti-Titan weapon that you probably haven't seen yet.
What are you looking at? What are you pointing at?
I'm just... Looking at the XP, kills get you a lot, challenges get you a lot as well. Good to know. Different kinds of challenges.
Yeah. Well, there's one.
All right,
burn cards.
We want to look
so, at... So, yeah, the amped mat. Mm-hmm. This is a new anti-Titan weapon. It's actually really cool. I got a chance to try this out down in L.A. Let's make sure to show that off. So, don't deploy that card... Alfredo, until you've got your Titan.
Ooh,
how do you deploy him when you're playing?
You hit Y before you respawn. So when you know your Titan is about to be ready,
okay,
you're going to respawn, go ahead and hit Y.
Gotcha. Respawn.
Yeah.
I made the game.
I mean, this, of course, is the beta, but, I mean, you got a couple, well, just very limited in terms of sights.
Yeah.
Sure, but you imagine there's going to be a ton.
I imagine there's going to be more. And then, of course, there's, like, what you would expect from the people who... made Call of Duty games like extend magazines, scatter fires, like there's a suppressor in there.
Sure.
Just things you would expect from any shooting game in general.
I like that as you go through them, it shows you down there the challenges that were a part of it.
For sure.
A lot of stuff to keep bringing you back. Games are good at that nowadays.
They are very good at that. The long tail, we call it, Greg.
Speaking of the long tail, Gregway, David tweets at IGN, hashtag Titanfall, and says, will more Titans be added in a future DLC? What do you think DLC for this game is going to be?
Maps are obvious. I mean, that's,
cool. Yeah.
Of course.
Sure.
You know, they kind of have the three archetypes, like small, fast one, medium, all-around one,
right.
Slow, heavy one, slow, super powerful one. So
they've got their bases covered.
Yeah, that's...
They know what they're doing.
But yeah, maps, I mean, I'm sure the first... We can expect at least a couple map packs. I just want to know how many maps the game has. We don't even know.
What's the
Respawn hasn't said.
For you, what would the perfect amount be? How many maps do you want to see in this game?
I think if they shift, so considering this is a multiplayer only game,
right.
There's no single player components of this whatsoever. I think 8 is the bare minimum where they could get away with it. I think, you know, if it's less than 8, then people are going to freak out and probably not buy the game or buy it and just...
Bitch.
And well, they'll do that anyway. But then, stop playing after a little while. They will not hang with it. But I feel like a dozen is a pretty good amount.
Yeah.
And especially, there are 12 good maps. I mean, hopefully it's not like 6 good maps and 6 lousy filler ones. If the 2 that are in here are any indication, they're going to be really good.
And, yeah.
I mean, again, you have... For people that don't know, we've touched on it a little bit, Greg, but this... The people making this game, it's Infinity Ward. It is the people, the original Infinity Ward, most of them. The people that made Call of Duty 1, 2, so...
They made the Call of Duties that started the whole Call
exactly.
of Duty.
Exactly. They made Call of Duty what it is, you know, with all due respect to the current Call of Duty developers.
Of
so, and their Call of Duties always had plenty of maps.
Okay.
So
looking at history,
based on their track record, I would expect burn card. We got two minutes to go.
We just all got excited to see it. Alfredo never dies, so we don't get to see that screen often. You're really good, Alfredo. Somebody had asked, but it already went down the thing, so I'll ask you for you. Has there been any talk about a season pass or anything for that? For DLC?
I don't think Respawn has commented on it. It would sure seem to make a lot of sense, you know,
because
but I haven't heard anything. I'm sure they'll announce that ASAP if it's going to happen.
Remember, ladies and gentlemen, we are still going for another hour and 15
kick
minutes.
Kick him!
We want you to be part of it. Tweet at IGN, hashtag...
One minute, what do you think? Can you stay alive?
It's
too late. The moment has passed, Alfredo.
Alfredo.
Yep.
John tweets and says, what's the weapon recoil like on both the infantry and Titan weapons? Similar to Call of Duty's weapon recoil?
I would say, if not less, there's not much weapon recoil at all. Mm. If anything, it kicks straight up, so it's completely predictable.
Right. That's what I was finding, too. As bad as I am at first-person shooters, I was lining it up and bringing it up a little bit, but I could keep it on target.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, the recoil is not even an issue in this game.
It's the future. There's less recoil.
Yeah, of course. Yeah. The guns have been perfected.
Get in there.
Oh.
There you go.
Oh,
no!
I have no idea.
Not Daft Punk or whoever that was.
We good? We good for a time?
Oh, well, we need. Wait, we want that. Wait. We want that burn car. Actually, well, wait a minute. No, we don't. I'm confusing myself already. Our burn card is for an anti-Titan weapon. So actually, we could grab it any time because it's to fight Titans, not to be in the Titan. My brain doesn't work.
It's fine, don't worry. We're asking you to pull a lot of information out about a game that you got to play a giant portion of, put it all on ice, and then today's the day. The codes go live.
Yeah, we're like unfreezing
an
my
hour
brain right
before
now.
You get in here. So, but you can only use the burn card from a spawn screen, right?
Right, while you're dead, you can activate it for your next life.
Gotcha.
Rodeo! Yeah!
Got it.
You got this guy. Yeah, he's doomed.
Oh. Woo! Ryan.
Yeah.
Space Invader asks, do you think they will add in custom camos like they did for the Call of Duty series?
Gosh, I hope so.
Yeah.
Burn it. Card. Let's do it.
Here we go!
Imp Mag Long.
So, find a Titan. Hit left on the D-pad to select your anti-Titan weapon. Yeah, they've got two Titans out on the battlefield.
There you go.
Shoot
frame.
One.
Just shoot frame.
There he is. Same on your mini map to the right.
Yep.
Oh.
Spine kick.
Right around the corner.
You gotta get him with his cooldown.
Here we go.
Running?
Where's he going? Come
Where
on!
You running?
You're 30 feet tall!
Yeah, you got the mag launcher.
It's like a cool grenade launcher.
This is actually very really cool.
Yeah, I got to try this one in LA and it was really effective. He's just running from you.
Is it a magnet so it's like locking onto him?
I don't know. I had it so briefly.
It seems like it's just a lob, but it's very forgiving in terms of the radius.
Gotcha.
Oh, you nuked him! Oh, it doesn't work very well against you.
The anti-Titan weapons actually generally don't. I like that your Titan's ready to go here.
Like all the the little grenades just kind of rolled to the ground.
To clarify, you just used one of your burn cards.
Yep.
Yes.
Wade immediately has a question, just to clarify. Are burn cards only used per spawn, per match, or do you get them for life?
Per spawn, and then that card's gone now.
Gotcha.
He'll need to earn more cards by playing.
That
card is gone from his deck.
How is he earning them? I know there was one where he snuck up on a guy and shot him. Is it just based on, you killed this many people?
Yeah, I don't know if it's tied to kill streaks or challenges. And to see if we can observe any patterns here.
All right, get out your notepad.
Scientific research.
There we go! Neo, this guy!
Nice!
Nice. Alfredo, you're good.
We should have him do every live stream from now on.
Sure.
Just play them.
Because I'm not doing my reputation any favors.
You probably got knowledge.
In all seriousness, for real though, you're being, you get that notification when you're being rodeoed, pretty hopped up. I genuinely do enjoy watching this game almost as much as I enjoy playing it.
Because
there's just so many cool things going on.
Moses tweets at IGN, hashtag Titanfall, which automatically enters him for the chance to win the Titanfall Collector's Edition we have. He says, will Titanfall have an actual story or just focus more on the gameplay? Is there no, I forget, some idiot out there walked behind me and was like, there's some kind of campaign. Storyline they're putting in. I don't know why are we fighting?
Well, it's
why do we live in an economy where you can drop Titans and kill them 2 seconds later? That doesn't seem
possible. There is a little bit of a backstory and... They call the multiplayer campaign multiplayer because, I guess in the final version, we saw at E3, the E3 demo was, you drop in and what you were supposed to, the whole point of the, they basically just sort of frame little mini narratives around the multiplayer matches, but it's not a campaign or story as you would normally think of it.
That's fine by me.
Yeah.
When I'm in giant robots doing cool stuff, using mag launchers, I don't mind. Oh my gosh, somebody's actually better than Alfredo for a change.
Oh, he has more deaths.
Is that more important to you? These are the things you have to teach me.
But 4 Titan kills for him, though.
Yeah.
That's pretty badass.
I'm going to start hunting some Titans down. Let's see if we can get into
it. Watch out, world.
Titan Hunter.
What do we unlock?
Extra burn card slot.
The sniper rifle.
Sniper rifle.
Are you a sniper guy, Alfredo?
I'm not.
I'm not either. I can't.
I can shoot the gun.
That's about it. I am able to fire the gun.
Okay, longbow sniper rifle, 6x scope. Stabilizer, that's probably good to eventually unlock.
Ooh. She looks cool. She looks like Tali in Mass Effect.
Very much.
Tactical ability. We want probably a cloak with this.
EA gonna say. Oh, wait, they're publishing this game.
Oh, that's pretty
emergency
cool.
Emergency induction.
Yeah, let's talk about the arc grenade. So this is it's sort of an EMP grenade. It just fuzzes out. It effectively blinds the Titans so that you can then hopefully run up on them, either escape or run up on them and rodeo them. So it's a different kind of grenade.
This I really like because this will automatically detect all the grunts and specters. So that kind of helps you weed out who are like
priority targets.
Yeah. What was that?
Do they look different on your map?
So your pilots, when they shoot, they come up on the map, so they come up red. Like red, and they come up like a lighter hint of red.
Okay.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, remember, we want you to be part of this show. Tweet at IGN, hashtag Titanfall.
Oh, what's the stim again? Stim ability that you've unlocked?
Movement speed increase.
That's cool, so you get to a little turbo action, basically.
Yep. The sniper would probably go cloak. I think it looks pretty good. Oh, yeah, awesome. We got the power cell thing ability going on. So essentially
recharge the ability quicker,
faster. Nice. It's a good combination there.
Alfredo, you're taking this like a duck to water. McCaffrey, you've played a dozen hours of it. Chad tweets at IGN, hashtag Titanfall, and says, any tricks you've learned so far that are really helpful for taking down the Titans?
I was going to share another tip. I guess I'll save it for later. But
for
taking down the Titans, for me, it's every Titan has the little jets. Mm-hmm. They're not jump jets. You can't get off the ground, but to quickly strafe in any direction, you can do 2 of them real quick before it has to recharge.
Right, they have little bars.
So you know, don't just stand there and go, you know, head to head with a guy. Like, if you anticipate when he's going to fire, strafe out of the way, and you can get the leg up. So
gotcha.
Definitely use those little boosters.
Okay, Alfredo, what do you got for tips? Taking out a Titan.
Go invis.
Okay.
Invis really helps a lot. Honestly, play it smart, right? Like, you always want to flank, whether it be a Titan or a pilot, or just flank them. Come from behind, you'll never see it coming.
Gotcha. Everybody remember to be part of the show, tweet at IGN, hashtag
We gotta get you trained to wall run, my friend.
Oh, yes.
That's the number one thing I'm noticing, Greg.
It's so easy to fall into conventional gameplay.
Because we've been playing Call of Duty every year for the last 8 years, or even Halo, so we're not used to being able to wall run. Oh, you got this.
Oh, hit marker.
Is that what it's showing you? Is that the little guy's outline?
Oh, I'm so bad at sniping. Jeez. I apologize.
You're better than me. Brain him.
Oh, hit marker again.
What is hit marker? What does that mean?
The little X.
It's
so that just means you hit.
You hit him, but
you didn't kill him. So like, what is this deal? You have a silhouette down in your scope there. Is that showing where your bullet landed?
Oh,
I guess. Okay, like, so you have the body shot. Body shot. 2 minutes.
I'm gonna tweak my sensitivity a little bit. Maybe like a higher one.
As soon as your screen goes red, dead.
Very high.
Very high, look at you.
Daniel tweets at IGN, hashtag Titanfall, and says, is there anything similar to dog tags from the Battlefield games in Titanfall?
I don't think so.
Nothing to pick up out there?
Not that I've seen.
Ooh! It's gonna be fun to dig in all these challenges.
And then have them be wiped away.
Then do it all again in a month.
Yeah, I've done this 3 times already.
Yeah.
I'll do it 2 more, too.
Why 2 more here and then?
Once for the review, and then once for the final
gotcha.
At-home version.
Yeah, of course, we're playing on the Xbox One version, not the PC. Kids were asking that. That guy just kicked that guy to death.
The PC beta is, their PC does have the beta if you want to
play on. Simultaneously, right now.
I think it's titanfall.com/beta if you want to sign up.
Oh my goodness.
It's not a question, but Big D tweets at IGN, hashtag Titanfall, and says, this game is amazing, yo.
I agree.
We all agree with you, Big D. We're big fans. Thanks for being a Big D fan of IGN as well.
Yeah, I mean, it's very clear the gameplay of this game is unbelievably fun.
Yeah.
The possible pitfalls come from how many maps are there? You know, like I said, if there aren't that many maps, that could be a big problem.
Yeah.
How many modes are there? If it's just these three modes, that's going to get old. And, you know, how good are the maps? What are the other unlocks? What are the other perks?
What's going to keep you playing?
Yeah, there is still plenty that could go wrong with this game, but the core of it is the most fun I've had in quite some time.
Well, even if it isn't great, it has a great nut to build from.
Exactly.
That Deku nut will grow into the mighty Deku tree.
What you said.
William tweets at IGN, hashtag Titanfall.
Between Worlds is so good.
I know, it's really good. Is there any way to kill someone on the back of your Titan who is Rodo-y?
Yes, Alfredo's going to do it, I promise you, at some point. Notice how I'm playing.
Is there just a button to hit to grab him and yank him off you?
So
someone lands on your Titan, so and they're shooting
you.
You
need
thing.
To get out.
Oh, you can't kill him?
Get out, and then shoot him off your Titan's shoulder.
Okay.
Or if you have helpful teammates, just have them.
Sure, yeah. That's helpful.
Now, there is a perk we're going to unlock later for the Titan, a Titan ability. It lets off this cloud of smoke, like electrified smoke, that I think, I'm not 100%, I believe it will zap off somebody rodeoing you.
It's hard to say, right?
When you say it fast, it's rodeoing, because it's not supposed to be a verb.
No.
But I believe that smoke, electrified smoke ability on the Titan will fling him off like a bug zapper.
Right.
Yeah, I think that's unlocked around level 11 or so. Yeah. What are you now, Alfredo?
I think we're at like
8 or 9?
7, 8.
Okay. Punch him.
There you go.
Yeah!
Oh, I got it!
Time keeps on slipping.
They're funny. Respawn's funny.
They are. They're clever people.
They did a good job.
There's a reason that they made a billion-dollar franchise for Activision.
Speaking of franchises, Danny tweets at IGN, hashtag Titanfall, and says, with the success which is bound to come.
You got landed on.
I got landed on.
That's awesome. Yeah.
Do you think more? It's fine. No, you should be commentating on the game. You're doing great. Do you think more studios will ditch the single-player experience? I hope not.
So, we're already seeing this a little bit. I think this is going to be it's not going to be an overwhelming trend, but we're starting to see it this generation already. I'll give you another example of a game we just saw. There's some awesome coverage on IGN that just hit this week. Evolve, which is the new game from the creators of Left 4 Dead, Turtle Rock Studios.
Yeah.
We've got a big written preview, some video stuff on IGN for that if you look up and just Google IGN Evolve. And that game doesn't have a proper single player. It's like Left 4 Dead in that it is just basically an endlessly replayable multiplayer game. So what's interesting about games now, Greg, is how much information is available to the developers. Because just about everybody is connected online now. So, you know, when somebody plays Call of Duty that's connected to Xbox Live or PlayStation Network, you know, Activision and the developers know exactly how far they got in the single player, if they played it at all, how much multiplayer time they put in. So they're, you know, they've got statistics, and that's how they make these decisions. So that's a big.
Oh! You guys are like, I'm just gonna climb out.
Kicking the booty to.
Trying to get to you.
And that injury, but, you know, so that information is used to inform big decisions in these games. Like, should we even bother with a single player? Oh, well, it turns out that only 10% of people that bought our last game even played the single player. Right. So no, we're not going to bother doing that. We're going to invest our resources in the multiplayer that people do play.
That's the thing. I think Danny's taken, I think, the wrong look on it, right? My look is that we're at a point in this industry where we can support so many different types of experiences.
Yes.
I would much rather, if Respawn sits down and is like, we want to make a multiplayer game, that's why people play our games, what they know us for, no single player, great, don't do that. In the same breath, I don't want Infamous to be like, we're a single player game, but we need multiplayer. Put it in there.
Exactly what I was going to say, Greg, is that we've seen it actually just fracture, go in both directions. Instead of, you know, for many years during the now concluded generation, the 360 PS3 generation, you saw games that would just add multiplayers because publishers thought, oh, I need to check that mark on the back of the box or else nobody's going to buy my game.
I mean, Tomb Raider's that great example, right?
Terrible
Everybody
multiplayer.
Everybody loves Tomb Raider
great
single-player.
Single-player
Nobody
game.
Plays the multiplayer.
And we're starting to see now publishers have begun to wise up and they're not afraid to ship single-player-only shooters anymore,
right.
like a BioShock Infinite, for instance. And now we're also not afraid to ship multiplayer shooters anymore, like an Evolve or a Titanfall.
Exactly.